But if you check out, both of you, job's yours.
Oh, I told you, they're clean.
Is this gonna be a problem? Running your prints?
No. No, it's not gonna be a problem.
You're next, partner.
We should be checking you out.
Huh? Hands.
Yeah, yeah. Knock yourself out. Kinda good?
I'll be in touch.
He won't care if you're cops. If you don't check out, he will kill you.
Okay, how solid are these IDs that you created for us, Jerry?
They're solid so far. As long as it doesn't dig too deep, we're good. I think.
Hey, thanks. I'm gonna go get my will sorted out.
He's kidding, right?
I have faith in you, Jerry. I don't know. No markings.
Take her down just in case we have to go.
Yeah.
Detective Danny Williams with the 5-0 Task Force. I need help landing this plane.
You're a cop?
Hey, put down the gun.
Put yours down. Put down the gun. I'm not gonna ask you again. I'm not gonna have to.
Shooting down.
I got it.
Request switch to channel 17 for immediate assistance.
Don't you answer that.
If I don't answer it, we're gonna die, both of us. Either we shoot each other or this plane goes down. You understand that? Does that make sense to you? Stay away.
Steve,
you got it, man.
All right, you know what? You win. You win. You're all right, Steve.
I'm gonna die, man.
No, you're not. Just hang in there. You're gonna be all right. All right?
Buddy?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Steve, all right, you. I need you to do something for me, all right?
Focus on getting the plane.
Do what I talk to me. Do what I tell you to do, or I'm gonna drop this thing in the water. You understand?
What do you want?
I want you to put your hand on his neck and tell me if you feel the pulse, okay?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? Keep your hand on his neck. Either you feel a pulse or you don't.
Okay, done.
Now you're gonna have to put her down on the water.
All right, control, that's not gonna work, okay? My partner, he's unconscious. If I put this thing down in the water, I'm not gonna be able to get him out of the plane, and he's gonna drown.
You don't have a choice, Detective.
Yeah, I got a choice. I'm gonna put this thing down on the beach, okay? Hey, Steve, listen to me. I know you've never been any good at listening to me, but right now you got no choice, you stubborn son of a bitch. Do not die. Hey, listen to me. Do not die, okay? I'm not landing this thing for you to die on me. You understand? Huh? Good. Good. All right, here we go.
Commander McGarrett has suffered a devastating trauma to his liver. A bullet is cut into multiple fragments, making the entire organ inoperable. If he doesn't receive a new liver in the next few hours, he will
just
die.
Save everybody some time. Steve and I are the same blood type, so just, you know, let's use mine.
He's come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we
need. You gonna make me watch a soap opera?
Game's gonna keep me up wanting to go to sleep. What's to put me to sleep?
You wanna go to sleep? I can bounce this lamp off your head. You go right out.
You want me to turn it up?
Whatever idea it was to have me share a room with you to help me with my recovery is a complete idiot.
You realize you didn't have to give me your liver.
Where were you gonna get one, Steve? At the supermarket? Of course I had to give you my liver. What are you talking about?
I'm gonna have to listen to this for the rest of my life, aren't I? I'm gonna have to listen to this forever. This speech about the selfless sacrifice you made on my behalf.
No, because, Steve, I am not like you, okay? I give without the expectation of thanks, all right? And do me a favor, please. Try to take care of the thing. I had it for 39 years. It means a lot to me, okay? You probably wreck it in 2 weeks.
How am I gonna wreck it?
I don't know. You like getting shot at. What do I know?
I like getting shot. You think I chose to get shot? How about this? If I hadn't taken those bullets for you, it'd be my liver in your body. How about that?
Oh, hold on.
Hold on.
You didn't save my life. Steve, you were on the wrong side of the plane when we got shot at, okay? That's A. B, there is zero chance if the roles were reversed here, you'd be giving me a piece of your liver, okay? No chance.
How can you say that? You saying I'm not generous?
No, you're not generous. I've never even seen you take your wallet out of your pocket. There's no way you're giving me one of your vital organs.
Oy. If this liver comes with your negative attitude, I swear to God, I'm gonna cut it out myself.
Crazy. It's crazy. It's not like I'm asking for a thank you, Steve. I'm not saying give me a speech or a gift or anything like that, but you're a big, giant ingrate. You know, my son, who I gave bone marrow to, he was more grateful than you are. But come to think of it, he's 4 years old and he's more emotionally mature than you, so it makes complete and total sense.
He's a kid. I promise you, Danny, you give him time, he's gonna grow up to hate you just as much as I do.
Okay, that's enough.
You do realize the curtain doesn't block sound, right? I know you can still hear me.